You talking to me? You talking to me?
I was talking earlier on about getting angry and getting offended. It'd be ironic now if I got into a road rage incident. But I very rarely lose my temper with people. And I have worked in jobs where you would lose your temper. I've worked in teaching, I've worked in security. In other words, I've worked in controlling people's behaviour, and people are very, very annoying animals. But maybe that's why my patience has been so tested over the years. It's been honed, it's been trained. People in those jobs will try to wind you up. Kids will do anything they can to get under your skin. And working in security, working in nightclubs, if you have ejected someone or you have refused them entry, they will do anything in order to make you lose your rag. Because if you lose your rag, you're going to lose your job. And they'll even say, yeah, come over here, step outside the club, come and fight me across the road, when they know that you can't do that because you'll lose your job. But I don't know, some things are worth losing your job over. Yeah, some things are worth it. I was up at Speaker's Corner a while back, and I was doing the rounds as usual, asking people if they had anything they wanted to talk about and whether they'd be willing to speak about it on camera. And one guy said, I want to talk about National Socialism. Okay. What do you know about National Socialism? He asked me. I said, well, that's the proper term for Nazism. He said, yeah, I want to talk about that. I'm in favour of it. Interestingly, this chap was not white, although Nazism is a so-called white supremacist ideology. This was a British Asian individual. He said, yeah, I want to talk about Nazism, but I can't talk about it in front of the camera. This guy's obviously a fan of Hitler. I said, why not? And he said, Jews control the media, and you can't say anything about the Holocaust, you can't deny the Holocaust. He's also a Holocaust denier. Why not? Oh, if I did, I would lose my job. Okay, so he thinks if he on camera says what he truly believes, he'll lose his job. Okay then, talk about it and lose your job. Violence. People become violent when they're angry. Violence should always be a choice. It should be controlled. If you're going to be violent, it should be a conscious decision. And I think the only acceptable times to be violent are in self-defense and in the sporting context. Any other time, there is no reason to resort to violence. That's where I think that's where I stand on that one. But if someone ever does annoy you,
you talking to me?
My tip is, imagine, don't actually do it, but imagine that you are having a physical confrontation with them, and imagine that you're having the fight with them. Don't really have it, just imagine you're having that fight. And you probably know in your heart how that fight would go. If this person is roughly of your size, and you are trained in fighting, and you have more experience in fighting than them, then you would probably dominate them in a fight. Usually that's the way it goes. If people are matched for strength, the person with the most experience, the most training in fighting or violence will win the fight. I mean, that's not rocket science. And even if the person is bigger than you, but you are vastly more experienced in violence, then you will probably still win the fight. But there comes a point at which technique and physicality even up. And if someone is much bigger and physically stronger than you, even if you're more trained in fighting, that strength will begin to show. I mean, there are weight classes in boxing and wrestling and mixed martial arts for a reason. So in your mind, and be true to yourself, imagine that you're having that fight with that person. And if it's a fight that you would easily dominate and easily win, then why are you angry with the person? As Saddam Hussein said, the monkey laughing in the tree doesn't bother the lion. The lion walks on. So if a little monkey is laughing at you and you're a lion, don't worry about it. You could swat him away with one paw. And whenever anyone who I know I could physically dominate in a fight and absolutely destroy them, which is a lot of the keyboard warriors, I'm not offended. I don't mind. I literally just laugh. Equally, if you're in a confrontation with someone who is bigger than you or is more trained, more experienced in fighting, and you know that they would physically dominate you in a fight if it got to it, then you kind of have to respect that. You do kind of have to respect that, and I do respect the law of the jungle. And if someone is bigger than and more experienced in fighting than me and would intimidate me in that way, you know what? Even if I disagree with what they're saying and what they're calling me, I kind of respect it. I kind of respect it because if I know, if it came down to it, there's nothing I could do. There would be nothing I could do in a one-on-one situation. So yeah, I respect that. I respect that law of the jungle. And I guess the only time when the anger should overcome you, when you feel that grudge and you can't let go, is when you're not sure whether that person would win in a fight or whether you would win. When there's two dogs of a similar size, I think it's that doubt, that subconscious doubt, when you want to prove, if you want to prove it. And if you're getting angry with somebody because they're insulting you verbally and you want to act out the physical confrontation, I think that's a sign that you can't decide whether you would win or they would win, and it's close, and you want to settle it somehow.